Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to BFL Reacts, and welcome back to more Infinity Train. This is Book 2, Episode 4, The Toad Car. So, expecting to see some frog people here. I don't know if they're gonna be... Oh no. I'm getting flashbacks to Amphibia. The void is reopening. I'm feeling empty again. Nah, but I'm wondering if we're going to see, like, I don't know, what kind of frog people we're going to be seeing here. Usually when I think frog people in cartoons, I always get a flashback to the fairy episode of Over the Garden Wall, which is a really good episode. Not that that episode has any bad episodes, really. Or that series has any bad episodes. Pretty great series. But last time, Jesse started to open up to MT, and we saw his number go down, but only very slightly, because he's had a small number ever since he came in. It's really seeming like... We're taking it by inches with him as he becomes more independent, more of a free thinker, and less of a pushover, less of a people pleaser. I'm very animated with my speaking today for some reason. The people in pursuit of MT showed up. I can never remember the name of whatever organization they're part of, but they showed up right at the end of last episode. So I assume that we're going to be picking up immediately, probably hiding from them in said toad car. But yeah, let's get into this episode. Excited to see what's going on, the toad car. Da-na-na-na. Oh man. Oh, nice, Alan Dracula. Come on, A-Drac. What is that piece of paper? I don't remember. Oh, it's a wanted poster, right? Yeah.
MT, what is going on?
My man is having his world rocked.
You're making a big mistake, son. You're harboring a criminal reflection.
Oh no.
Are you the criminal?
No. I mean, it's complicated.
It is pretty complicated. I forgot to move the camera over.
Jesse, do you know who she is? She's a dangerous extremist from our mirror world.
Come on.
She did it to her prime, and she'll do it to you too.
Come on, dude.
Oh boy, she hasn't told you anything, has she?
Ignore them.
Why? They've told me more about you than you have.
I understand why he'd want to listen to them.
You're a criminal.
Well, you're an idiot.
Oh my god, dude.
For trusting you.
Please don't kick me.
Oh no. Poor guy.
Well, ma'am, the only way to open the doors and get out of this here car is if you kick me.
Oh, no.
Please don't kick me.
Sorry, but if it's the only way...
Oh, you would.
What's that?
Oh, no.
Kicking a defenseless toad?
Oh, thank you very much.
That proves you're a criminal.
I am not a criminal.
I know where this leads, to kicking poor old chubby lover me.
Oh no, poor toad, man.
Do you even want to get off this train?
Yes, of course I do.
Then kick the toad!
What is A-Drac doing? Huh? Oh no. Ooh, quite a moral dilemma here. Talk it out with the toad.
Y'all need anything? Maybe some cookies and warm pond water?
No, that looks stupid.
Aww. Aw, the toad is there too. Is the toad gonna join the crew? Aw. He's gonna get hurt, huh?
Make him do it, Jesse!
Yeah, it's fine. Just do it already, Nate.
Aw. Aww. And he was part of it. That's Scott Menville from Teen Titans. I can't take him seriously. Aww. He's so agreeable that they made him be an asshole. I feel bad for him.
I'm so glad you're safe.
You are?
Fuck you.
You're not the bad guys, son. Look around. You're the hostage. All you have to do is leave that phone out till morning so we can pop through the screen reflection.
No, dude. Don't. No, Jesse. Make your own decisions here. No. Oh. Ugh. Holy crap. I feel bad for him, man.
Why should I trust somebody who sells out his own brother?
What?
Damn.
No, I didn't.
Yeah, well, he's probably fine.
I wouldn't know. I didn't get to talk to him before.
Oh my god, it was right after that he got sucked in, too. Damn.
Probably should have told you what was going on earlier.
Yeah.
Technically, I am a criminal, but I didn't do anything wrong.
Yeah, you're a criminal because the laws suck.
I wanted to live my own life, make my mm-hmm. own memories. That's against mirror law, and those Flex have been chasing me ever since.
Yes, we're coming back together again.
MT? Does it stand for Mirror Tulip?
It's not my name. I'm just letting you call me that.
Are we gonna get her own name this episode? Sweet. I'm glad that they're coming together. Holy crap! Kick the toad!
If all my time in this car has taught me one thing, the toad always gets kicked. Kick me straight in the Graceland.
Oh no!
Who cares? We gotta go. Let's just do it together.
I don't know how I feel about the toad being kicked.
Well, no, don't get too excited now. My body were
injured. Oh! Shout out Alan Dracula. Bring the toad, yay! Hey, sick. Are they out of commission now?
Thank you kindly for saving me from an existentially nightmarish existence. Goodbye!
Goodbye, toad.
Jesse, your hand.
Whoa! Huge jump down. Aww. Aw, she smiled. I love them. I did it in season one, I did it here again. I was so excited to get into the episode that I forgot to move my camera to the side at first. But this was another great episode. I loved the toad. And remember in episode two how I said I was worried that there would be some big conflict that would feel forced and, you know, push them apart? How I was worried about how that'd be handled? We got there. They handled it well. I loved it. Felt totally organic and natural. And this was just a great episode. I love the toad's voice. He almost sounded familiar. Let me see the toad. Ah, the toad was the creator of the show. That's why he was familiar. It was 1-1, I guess. I guess he probably has a cameo or a bit part in every book, maybe. I did recognize Scott Menville or Robin from Teen Titans as one of the bullies. That was a little bit distracting, I must admit. But I still think that scene was really well done. We saw, you know, how the agreeable, people-pleasing nature of Jesse hurt himself last episode. But now we've seen how it hurt other people, the people he cares about, his brother. I thought that was really well done. I felt bad for his brother, but also felt bad for Jesse, so it was a nice balance. And especially since he got sucked out of the train car before he could even apologize. Dude, that freaking sucks. And it was totally believable why Jesse would be kind of scared of MT. She really hasn't been honest with him, and here that came back to bite her in the butt, you know? People definitely ship MT and Jesse, don't they? I can kind of just tell. I'm not sure if I do. I'm not sure if I see them in, like, a romantic way. I kind of just see them as, like, kind of a good, like, platonic relationship right now, but I could definitely see it heading in that other direction. Although, unfortunately, kind of doomed to not last because he's not going to stay on this train forever, I would assume. He probably will eventually end up making his way off. But relationships, you know, whether platonic or romantic, stay with us for our entire lives. So, whatever happens between them, I am intrigued to see it progress. I just love their relationship through all the ups and downs we've had so far, and it's only been 4 episodes. So the writers have done a fantastic job of making me emotionally attached to them, for sure. I don't think I'm as connected to either character individually as much as I was Tulip in season 1, But their dynamic and what they do for each other, I'm very into it. I'm very, as a team, as a combo, I'm very into it. I like it. They complement each other very well. And on the policemen chasing them, I do wonder, are they trapped in that cart until like another passenger comes to get them? I don't know. You'd think that they would maybe carry a mirror on them if a situation like this were to arise. So I don't know. I don't know what's going to happen to those two now. I'm sure that we're going to see them again at some point, but they might be out of commission for a while now. Anyways, this was another great episode. I do think that I am done for the evening, though. I had a good 3-episode run here for this recording session. But yeah, I love this episode, as that's been a trend this entire recording session. All 3 I've really loved. So that was the Toad car. Let's see what the next one is. The Parasite car. Oh boy, that sounds exciting. Anyways, I'll see you guys on that one next time. Until then, peace.